Basketball isn't easy.
Welcome, everyone, to NBA Action here on 2K Sports. It's Sunday night. Welcome to our NBA presentation. It'll be the Philadelphia 76ers facing off against the Houston Rockets.
Welcome, folks. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for the latest presentation of our NBA basketball. Along with Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and our sideline reporter, Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. A quick check now at the starting lineups for both teams. And one of the guys we'll be seeing in this one, James Harden.
And I'll say this about him, Kevin. I mean, it looks like he's made of rubber sometimes because defenders just bounce off him when he's driving the lane. What a finisher.
And there's something else on his resume that can't be overlooked. Just how many times he's taken over at the end of close games and carried his team to the win.
Houston Rockets here at home in an interconference matchup should be a good one. And guys, this is the first they're seeing of the 76ers this year. A year ago, they each gained a victory at home, but couldn't secure a win on the road.
And, you know, this is a team you want to capitalize on when you play them, but that wasn't the case last year. They split two games.
Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
Incredible timing on the alley-oop.
He absolutely hammered it down.
And that's the play we're going to remember when this game is all said and done.
And so the Houston Rockets get the first points of the ball game. Pass to Magician. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Shot clock at six. Great pass to set up the lay-in. And to touch on Steve's point real quick, I'll bet they consider that game they lost to them to be, you know, the one that got away.
And I would think there's no doubt they're going to be looking to rectify that and sweep them this time around.
Here's Beverly after the made shot from George. And now just over a minute played here in the first. To the paint, tipped, tries to save it. Out of bounds, Houston takes possession. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Kevin, Mike D'Antoni and I got a chance to talk for just a bit. One of the most important things he wants his team to do defensively in this game is to maintain pressure on them on the perimeter and not allow them to get into any rhythm or flow in their long-range shooting game. We'll see how disruptive they are, Kevin.
Doris, thank you. Obviously, Clark, the three ball is a big concern for any defense.
Well, yeah, it is, Kevin, but the upside is you're not getting broken down in the lane and you're not giving them free throws, but you still have to challenge those shots.
Prime Time gets it to go. Prime Time's got his first bucket of the night.
Man, how about the dexterity for this big guy? I mean, he is really smooth around the basket.
Here's Beverly, and he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in. And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. Passes it to Insana. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
The 76ers shooting their first free throw attempt on the night. And that drops, so they now lead by one. For the Houston Rockets, they come in off a good outing against the Mavericks in Dallas.
And they played outstanding team defense in that win, Park. Nobody got stuck on an island. Everybody was helping. Great rotations. It really looked like they were together in that game.
Yeah, and even when they were rotating different players in and out, Steve, I thought their communication was five-star and the teamwork was very strong.
Harden's shot is good.
And they're nearly perfect from the floor early on. Four of their first five shots they've drained.
Right side, George. Jacks up a three. That's good. Magician's got six.
Red hot right out of the gate. Four for four shooting.
He kicks it to Beverly. From the line. Misses off the left iron.
Man, a nice job there defensively, just getting a hand up enough to bother the shot.
Yeah, that was very nice. Impressive. It made it a much more difficult shot.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
Philadelphia shooting their second and third shots at the line right here. Both free throws good from Insanity.
Boy, his free throw shooting, just another reason. He's such a good all-around player.
So for the 76ers, their last game, a win against the Hawks in Atlanta.
And you know what was most impressive? They've wasted very few possessions.
Oh, ridiculous.
What a move.
Tore it down that time.
Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying hard to get back into this game like this.
Yeah, definitely a jam with emphasis. A big apostrophe or exclamation point. How about maybe even a question mark?
Well, you know what the questions are about now. It's their defense, that's for sure.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
I'd say that shot was well within his range.
You think so? I mean, I was pretty good from 2 feet and in myself. That's a gimme there.
Rockets trail by seven. And now the first timeout call here for the Rockets.
Yeah, he's trying to take the wind out of their sails here. I mean, they're on the wrong end of a bad run. They got to sort things out.
I think things were very close to spiraling out of control if he didn't burn one there.
Spiked it away. Here's Prime.
Oh, get it! Oh, what's out now?
Putting on a show for these people.
I cannot believe he pulled that one out in the course of an actual game. Are you kidding me?
Oh, man. Might as well want it if you got it, Clark.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Rain Man. That's his first foul. And the Rockets making a change here. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Looking to end the run, and that one's good, Simmons. Philadelphia leading by seven. And he lobs it up toward the rim. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Here's Ariza. The layup off target.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Here's Simmons. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. 76ers have gotten off to a tremendous start. 7-7 here in the first quarter. Rain Man passes to Prime Time.
Oh, what a huge play. Oh, he's explosive, Kevin. I mean, a lot of time, all it takes is a basket or two to really get his motor running. And suddenly, he becomes almost impossible to handle.
And whereas almost all players go through their ups and downs, Steve, that's not the case with him. He just goes about his business the same way every night.
Harden's shot is good. The 76ers have gone 8 of 8. What a hot start for them. A nice shot by George.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint. I guess the good news is They've taken away the outside shot.
Well, you know what? It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they're going to allow inside looks as easy as that.
You know, something we're seeing less and less of these days, that little finger roll.
The shot's good from prime time.
You know, they've been so effective when they've been able to get the ball inside.
Some real shortcomings from this defense. I mean, they've given up 5 straight looks in the paint.
Here's Beverly. He hangs. Oh, that's blocked. They retain possession. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound.
Boy, I tell you what, the complexion of this game would be completely different if he'd shot the ball anything like he's capable of.
Man, great ball movement. They're just picking this defense apart with their passing.
Well, how about the 3 P's, Steve? Purposeful, precise, passing. We love it, and so does this team, because they're taking advantage of it.
And there's the pass to Magician. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful. Magician's got 8 points.
They're allowing a sky-high field goal percentage. That won't get it.
Not at all. They've been able to score with ease.
It's hauled in by George. First quarter, already a double-digit ball game. 76ers lead by 11. After this break, we'll be back with the start of the second quarter on 2K Sports.
This Tuesday, December 6th, Kawhi Leonard and the San Antonio Spurs take on the Cleveland Cavaliers. Be there.
Welcome back, everyone. A lopsided first quarter in the books already as we start the second quarter. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
Well, they're trying to play fast and trying to put the defense on their heels.
They've gotten their fair share of points off turnovers so far tonight, too.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. So on the floor for Houston. Bounds. Philadelphia takes possession. Let's take a moment to look at the 2K leaderboard and see last year's high-scoring teams. The Rockets fourth.
I just loved how this team attacked their opponents. I mean, you could see their confidence growing as they continue to put up points on the board.
And blocked. Now the 76ers on the break. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. No good from outside. Rockets trail by 8. Williams with 3. Gets it to go. Williams has got 6 points.
That was simply a defensive breakdown there, Kevin. He was all alone for that shot. It was a warm-up jumper.
That drops.
They are owning the lane right now. Every one of their last 10 points has come either at or near the rim.
Great looks in tight because they're finding lanes to the hoop whenever they want them.
A three-pointer off the mark. The 76ers leading by 7. Cowboy passes to the Beast. Rebound by Williams. Rockets have gone 2-4 shooting the ball here in the second. It's Brown on the wing. And that's a foul called on the Beast. That's his first foul. And the Rockets making a change here. Just about a minute and a half has gone by here in the second. Brown, good. 76ers have gotten only one of their first 4 shots in the second quarter to drop. Smooth passes to the Beast. And easy 2 points on the layup.
Boy, he's so good at recognizing where the openings are and getting the ball to the rim.
And so here is Houston. They trail by 7. They'll be playing host to Toronto for the next one. They'll find themselves in the middle of this string of 3 straight at home.
some really good games going on, and that Toronto one has caught my eye.
Ryan Anderson is checked in for the Rockets. Williams with the steal. Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. Brown's got the ball. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Seems to me that anytime the game is on the line, he's perfectly willing to be the hero, or the GOAT for that matter. And that's what it takes to be clutch in big situations. You can't be afraid to fail.
And you've really got to also admire his steadiness. I mean, no matter what the situation is, he's not going to change his game and risk a drop off. Very consistent in his approach and production.
Brown, right side. Here's Anderson. And here in the second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played so far. Smooth, he's covered by Anderson. Clutch, and a miss there on the triple. Rockets trail by 5, and it's Houston on the break. Williams with the ball, now guarded by Clutch. Williams gets the bucket. Williams has got 8 points in the quarter.
Gotta love the finger roll up and over the defense.
Pass to Clutch. Get the shot. That one off the back iron and out.
The defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them.
And that one's good.
Well, it looks like he's finally found his footing in this game. His first quarter was a real struggle, but he's gotten it going now.
Takes a three. Another miss by Philadelphia. Houston's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. The drive by Gordon. That's blocked. And now Philadelphia on the break. The base passes to Cobb. Williams with the steal. And just over 3.5 minutes play here in the second quarter. And there's the foul. It's on Clutch. That's foul number 2 for him.
He's jammed himself up a little bit here with that second foul. But as long as he can avoid a third before the half, I think he's fine.
Stolen.
Good defensive instincts on display there.
Takes it from 10. That's good. Clutch has got his first bucket in this one. Rockets trail by 3. It's Brown with the drive. The second chance effort. And it's laid in by Gordon.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. 2 shots coming up. And this is what the schedule looks like for Houston. They'll be playing host to Toronto for the next one. And that will be the middle game of this 3-game homestand. And he makes the first. And the Rockets making a change here. Both free throws good from Smooth.
Boy, I tell you what, he does not look like your typical big man up there at the line. He has an excellent stroke and a percentage to match.
And Insanity picks up a foul. That's foul number 2 for him. Philadelphia on D. He dishes it to Ariza. To the middle, Gordon. The shot no good. Great D that time from Clutch. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. He squares up and sinks it.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today, ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass?
Well, if you just looked at assist as the measuring stick, they've been by far the better team.
Number 15. 1:15 left here in the second. Insanity off target with his 3.
Boy, with an open look like that, he is so gifted. Man, you've got to play better defense. Eventually, he's going to make you pay.
You got that right. I mean, he'll do it from 3-point land or anywhere on the perimeter, really, because he is a deadly shooter. You've got to do a better job defensively.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2. Moment to see how the schedule is looking for Philadelphia. They'll be playing host to Chicago for their next game. To start a 3-game homestand with that game.
Boy, a lot of fans around the league really focused on that matchup for Chicago.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Shooting 100% in the quarter. They've They made them all, taking full advantage at the line.
Well, it's a nice job of really making the most of their opportunities.
The Rockets making a switch here. Harden's checked in.
That's the risky run by staying out there as he picks up his third.
The Rockets shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Well, you look at last season's numbers, guys. They're down below 70% as a team from the line. Yeah, they're getting to the line an awful lot in this quarter, and it's not an accident. They've been very aggressive.
Yeah, it's been very intentional. I mean, they've picked up the aggression, and it could get him out of this hole.
It looks like he's finding his touch now because the shots are starting to fall.
Here's Beverly, number 15, goes back up, and that's 2 points on the layup. He has six.
Seems like they're on their heels every time defensively because the ball continues to go into the post.
Well, if they don't pick up the aggression, things are only going to get worse.
The shot's good from Smooth. And the 76ers lead by seven.
I really like the fact that he's getting the touches he needs here after not scoring a single point in that first quarter.
It's Harden with the drive. And there's a nice one-handed jam. They'd love to get one of those, the easiest 2 points possible. And a fierce finish.
Yeah, and that's exactly how they're going to cut into the lead, Kevin.
Yeah, that's why they've got to tighten up their D. And I'd be surprised if the defense allows any more free runs to the hoop like that.
And we're... through two here and a good one. Philadelphia ahead, up five. And coming up now, it's the Sprint Halftime Show with Damon Bruce. We'll return with the start of the third quarter in just a while.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
It's time for the Sunday Night Halftime Report. For Philadelphia, they have the lead against the Rockets in Houston. They've yet to lose so far this season and are looking fantastic in this one, too. Prime time making his presence felt early. The bucket looks about 5 feet wide for him. He hasn't missed one shot. Can you believe it? And midway through, the Rockets are still alive. Defensively, very disruptive. They've been effective forcing turnovers. Nice steal so far. James Harden has been locked in so far. He has 11 points, and he's been able to provide some nice assists as well. Now let's check out the other game still in progress. The Magic battling in a close one against the Atlanta Hawks. Second half of play, still anybody's game. A look now at some games yet to start. Over at Verizon Center, the Wizards will face off against the Cavaliers. 8 p.m. Eastern, that one gets started. And another game that's coming up for the Spurs, they'll be up against the Bulls in Chicago. That gets going 7:30 Eastern. That's it for us here in the studio. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And now, the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters.
Some excellent numbers in this one for Harden. He's got 11 points, and he's put one three-pointer on the board.
Going forward, I think it'd be a good idea to let him spend a little more time behind the arc. He looks like he has a nice touch from out there.
So on the floor for Philadelphia. He's back there with Smooth. Then it's Magician. And it's Clutch. And it's Cowboy in at the three spot. Offensive rebound to the inside. Beyond the arc. The shot is off. Good D by Ariza. Houston's won 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Back to Harden. Stripped it away. Now the 76ers on the break. That's good. And that's 10 points for Magician.
Great job capitalizing on that steal and getting the easy points in transition.
Exactly how it should be done after a turnover.
And Beverly kicks to Harden. The dish to Beverly. And again, it's the Rockets from deep.
Back-to-back threes for him. The defense is slacking off a little.
It does look like their energy is lacking at this point.
A signature slam right there from the big fella. How many of those have we seen before?
Now a timeout called by Houston. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Ball stolen. and the running. Here's Smooth. And the 76ers tack on two more.
Well, Kevin, he's got such a great focus as a shooter. You know, he's a very frustrating player to guard because unless you actually block his shot, you are not going to get in his head and affect him.
Steve, you know, his ability to come in and rattle off 10, 20 points in no time flat, that's a gift and a real asset for any team. Some guys need a while to get going, not him.
There's the triple, and that one's good. Magician's got 13.
He's got a nice stroke from long range, and, you know, he's not likely to pass up those opportunities when he gets them.
Here's Beverly. He's got 5. Shot denied.
I'd love to see them impose their will a little bit more on the backboard. Usually that's a great way to take control of a game.
Well, they haven't been able to do that yet, but it's something they're certainly capable of.
And the foul goes on the Magician. That's his first foul.
First team foul.
Anderson with the ball. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. No good from Beverly.
And you know why he was open there. They didn't commit too much defense to him, and you can see why. He has trouble making that shot.
Looked to me like the defender didn't get squared up and get his feet set.
Good work by the officials. A nice call. That play can be tough to judge sometimes.
Nene, he's checked in for Ryan Anderson. Magician passes to the Beast. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
You know, even from here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
Yeah, pretty obvious. And a good call by the official.
And the Rockets making a change here. He's perfect from the line this time. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. He feeds it to Beverly. Back to Harden. Can they get it? And Philadelphia grabs the miss. The Beast's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Well, time passed, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. Houston's on, 5 of 8 from 3-point land, 15 points and a deep ball for them tonight. Number 7, another miss by Houston. For Philadelphia, they've gone 6 of 8 on field goal attempts in the first. A 75% clip. Passes it to Cowboy. Down low. Pulls up. And misses it off the right side of the rim. Houston's gone into the 3-point range 4 times since halftime and buried 2 of them. Harden with it. Now guarded by Clutch. That is good.
Yeah, beautiful drive there, going right around the bigger man.
Philadelphia moving the ball around. Let's it go with a 3. Shot misses. The Rockets go the other way with it. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play. Harden dishes to Beverly. No good.
He's playing selfishly now, guys. He's just trying to get as many shots up as he can. Doesn't look at all concerned about his teammates.
Clutch the pass to the Beast. Missed inside.
You know, typically, guys, he has the body control to finish when he's in that tight. I'm not sure what happened there.
It's Harden with the drive. And slam dunk by Nene.
Up high and down hard with the one hand.
Got a little extra force with that one, didn't he?
Yeah, I think he's hoping to kind of get his teammates going a little bit, fellas.
Now, that was pretty. That was just a nice-looking reverse jam right there.
Use the rim, Clark, to protect the ball, I think, too, a little bit.
Yeah, did a nice job with it.
Yeah, no question. Kevin, great awareness and terrific finish.
The Rockets making a switch here. Picked off in midair. Cowboy passes to Clutch. Rejected by Simmons. And he recovers it. Second shot opportunity.
And that 4th foul might force him to scale back the aggression defensively a little bit. He does not want to pick up number 5.
And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the 76ers.
Their defense has been outstanding, Kevin. Closing out on shots, blocking a lot of them as well.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
Well, just as we expected, they've made the most of their chances at the free throw line. That's definitely been a factor so far.
It's Harden with the drive. It's rebounded by Cowboy.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior, no question. And that's, I think, the main reason they have this lead.
Hammer time.
And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Tell you what, he's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Absolutely insane with that dunk.
Well, now they're starting to rub it in, aren't they? How's that? Build up the lead, and here we go, folks. It's showtime.
And why not? I mean, the more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys on the ropes.
The Rockets making a switch here. Ariza's checked in. The Rockets shooting their fifth free throw of the game here. The 76ers leading by 11. The pass to Magician. Lays it up and banks it in. Cowboys got 6 points in the quarter.
I like the way they got the ball inside there.
Houston's gone 5 of 9 when they put up the 3-point shot tonight. Here's Simmons. Nice shot from 10 feet out.
Another good offensive possession for him. He's trying to shoulder the load here for his team.
And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a 3-point play.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these easy chances is going to do wonders for their confidence.
James Harden, he's checked in for the Rockets. That free throw good from the Beast.
Look at the free throw percentage. Unblemished since halftime, Clark. That's pretty nice.
I'd go farther than that, Steve. How about perfect?
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. They get a hand on it. Out of bounds, Philadelphia takes possession. And the Rockets making a change here. 19 seconds left here in the third quarter. And a foul on the shot. They'll go to the strike for 2. Number 15. And so he's picked up his final foul. And he will sit for the rest of this game. Both free throws good from Clutch. And here comes Harden. 16 points for him. Blocked. 3 seconds left. He lays it in. And that's now 10 points for Clutch.
Defender a little hesitant to offer.
Double-digit ball game. 76ers lead by 18. And do not go away, as we'll be back in just a few moments with the start of our fourth quarter coming up next.
This Saturday, December 10th, Carmelo Anthony and the New York Knicks take on John Wall and the Washington Wizards. Don't miss it.
Fourth quarter action starting up in what has been a one-sided show. Here's Rain Man. Beverly and Harden man the back. Nene is out there with Ryan Anderson. And it's Ariza in at the 3, the small forward. That's the 5 for Houston right now. Here's Beverly. Gets the 3-pointer to fall. Beverly's got 9 points now in just the second half.
He is pouring it on in the second half, guys. I mean, a much better showing than he had before the break. Slot.
Sloppy defense there. You can't let him get the ball in his hands down there.
Well, when he does, that's an automatic bucket.
Picked away. A solo fast break. Rips down the breakaway slam.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Now, here is Harden. Not a lot of room. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Rain Man. That's foul number two for him. Houston making a switch here. Dishes to Harden. Up and in on the layup.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
Some solid defense there from Insanity. Offside, George. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. That free throw good from George. Eric Gordon, he's checked in for James Harden. And George drops them both. Rockets trail by 19. Here's Beverly. Final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Number 35. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up. He's off on the first. Good on the second free throw. Philadelphia leading by 18. Rain Man passes it.
Oh, look out, man.
Already shaking. It's not possible what we just said. Clark, is that possible?
It is possible. I don't know what all that meant, but you're right, Clark.
Houston making a switch here. Simmons has checked in. And that free throw good from George. For Houston, they've gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Now a timeout called by Houston.
You know, he just isn't pleased at all with the looks they've given up defensively inside. So I think this timeout is all about trying to get his group to tighten up defensively.
They just don't look very sharp to me on the defensive side.
Here's Beverly from past the arc. Another miss by Houston.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the board.
Well, the main thing is they haven't allowed many second chance opportunities. And that is always going to allow you to maintain your lead. And another three-pointer to their second half total.
Yeah, they caught that long-range bug at halftime, and it's been pounds away ever since.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give them two chances at the free throw line here.
Yeah, nice body control there. Narrowly missing the shot. Would have been a three-point play.
Had a free look at it after the foul. Nice play.
Nene, he's checked in for the Rockets. Rockets trail by 20. Here's Beverly. They swipe it. Now the 76ers on the break. Here's Magician. And that one's on target from the wing.
And their field goal percentage continues to climb. They've really shot the ball well here today so far.
Yeah, and it's all about quality shot selection, smart shot selection. They've been very patient on offense.
And the basket by Gordon.
They're getting a bunch of their points outside of the paint. Three of their last five buckets are from three-point range.
But the defense isn't making them earn it. I mean, those shots have just come on easy, open looks.
Here's Insanity. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own. The Insanity's got 5 points now in the quarter. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. And the call will be against Primetime. That'll be his second foul of the game.
I like the call. I thought the defense was moving there.
Yeah, I think he slid underneath. Good blocking call that trip.
And here's Anderson for three. It's hauled in by George. George has got his fourth rebound in this one. He passes to Primetime. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
Tell you what, he's not an easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And I love how he goes with that one-hand tomahawk slam. Beautiful.
14. A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Ariza kicks to Beverly. sensational block.
An 8-rebound advantage like the one they have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference.
The shot's good from the Rain Man.
He's definitely got that shot in his arsenal.
Houston's gone 3-5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. Rob jumps up, finishes the break with a slam.
And the defense paying instant dividends, fast break basket.
Yeah, that transition was immediate. Didn't waste a second getting out on the break.
For Houston, they've gotten just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth, 4 of 9. Gordon dishes to Beverly. There's a minute 47 left in the fourth quarter. Lock at 6.
The D got there too late, and he'll go to the line.
First free throw is good. And the Rockets making a change here. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. The 76ers have gone on a tear here in the fourth. They're 8 of 9 on field goal attempts in the quarter. Stolen by Nene. Left side, Brown gets it to go.
Great job to hit his teammate on that move, Kevin.
Bobby. Philadelphia shooting 70% from the floor. Truly incredible work from this offense tonight. Pass to Raymond. Shoots from the high post. Cannot hit. So Houston will take it the other way. 1:16 left in the fourth. Williams with the ball. Now defended by Insanity.
Nene.
And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Yeah, the defender draped all over him.
Pretty plain and simple. Got him good there.
And the Rockets making a change here, so he can't get either to fall. Rain Man passes to Primetime. Taken away by Williams. Fires from deep. And that one's good.
Boy, if they could have had this kind of run earlier in the game, it might have made a big difference.
You know, I think a big reason behind the run, Steve, is that they're not getting pressured as much by the defense now that the game's all but finished.
Well, they'll get another chance. And taken away by Brown. There's the steal. And they're moving it up. Insanity, the pass to Raymond. And the officials call goaltending, so they'll award the basket.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
Can you hear the crowd kind of murmuring? I don't think they agreed with the officials on that one.
Steve, I tell you what, they're really letting them have it.
And George with the block. But they get it back. Tries again. The shot is off.
And a missed opportunity right there.
Definitely. I think he should have converted that one.
Prime time. Pass to Raymond. Nice D from Williams. And that's a foul called on Money. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line.
Two shots.
And the first one drops. And Sonnen nails both of them. Here's Rain Man. Elbow shot is on the way. It falls.
And the crowd here, of course, not happy about the outcome. But you know what? We saw a team tonight that came in prepared to do battle on the road. And they clearly wanted the win.
You know, they were determined to steal this game. And they showed it, Steve. Played harder and got the job done.
So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly controlling each end of the floor.
Hey, what more can you ask?
And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. And now we present the Jordan Player of the Game, Rain Man.
Also like this, there's not a second left. You know that tomorrow sunlight is over.